Now, before I start this video, just want to let you know that I got an SJ cam. I've wanted these from the start. Haven't really got the money for a GoPro, so I got one of these. I originally bought one because I see Evan Shanks had one, but my main concern was about getting one here in the UK, whether you get something that's legitimate or not. There's a guy who I've had a lot of interaction with recently called Joe. I think his YouTube channel is like Gas Stuck Garage or something like that. I'm sorry if I've forgotten the name. He gave me some good information on what they're like in the UK. He actually owns one himself, so thanks for that. You give me the kind of inspiration I need to actually just go out and buy one, because I know that quality is an important thing, video quality for these videos, so you might see a bit more content using these cameras. Try to keep this short just so you don't get too involved in this before we head to the video, so I'm hoping this is under a minute, so let's go straight into the video.
Morning, we are fixing this piece of shit today. When I bought this car, there's a bracket on the headlights broken off and the grill clips are broken. Managed to get online, managed to find a headlight pretty cheap. It's not too far away, so we're going to take a drive down there today to collect that and fit the new headlight on, and fingers crossed everything's okay there. So I'm hoping so. It looked pretty cosmetic, so a new headlight should fix that. So that will be pretty cool.
We are back. It's gonna get dark in a couple of hours, so I'm gonna cue the tools and give it a go right now. So step one, I nicked my stepdad's tools because I haven't got any at the moment. Rest in peace, Fiesta. Make it a cameo. So all I really needed was the socket set, and that was about it really. I just knew that I needed Torx bolts, and I may have needed something else, but the attachments were gonna be in it. One cool thing about the Lupo that I didn't know really when I initially got it, bonnets on struts instead of putting a like stick thing up, whatever you want to call it. Pretty cool. So you can see there where they've bodged the headlight and the bumper's cracked, the grill don't fit properly, so we're going to take the headlight out. There's just those torque bolts that are around, I think there's about 3 or 4 that I've got to take off, and the headlight should come out. So I'm just going to use the socket set with the attachment on to take those out. I'm quite happy really, because I thought with a newer car, see sometimes until that headlight stuff, you have to take the bumpers off and all that, and oh, I'm really looking forward to it. But it was literally just 3 or 4 bolts around the headlight and it comes straight off. You can see there some of the bolts are pretty rusty, that's just where they botched it. So it's just a case of taking those bolts off, which was fairly simple, which I was happy about. And then just disconnecting the electrical connection to the headlight. And then it's pretty much easy to just pull the headlight out. No real, just give it a bit of a jiggle and that was pretty much it. That just comes straight out. You can see the gap. And then on here you can see the two brackets, well, no, the one bracket, because the other headlight hasn't got one. That's what should have been on there, but that's what cracked off the headlight when the previous owner had a little crash. So what we're going to do here is we're going to be a bit haggard. I'm actually nicking the main bulb and the side light bulb out of the headlight. Purely because the old headlight's no use to be anymore because it's knackered. But the bulbs will be if one blows or anything anytime soon. So, worst good thing is to take the bulbs out. See there, the damage. She's not looking great, and that's obviously why the grill, the clips just weren't right, just wouldn't sit right at all. So that's something I'm probably just going to look at a later time. So for now we're just going to wipe the headlight back in and just tighten that up, make sure that fits okay, so we've actually got some light on the car and not light, and they line up okay because the beam was dodgy. So just doing the bolts back up, 4 Torx bolts holding the headlight on, and then that's pretty much done. And obviously the last thing, just make sure you've got your electrical connection put back in on the headlight and check that the bulbs are working. I'm pretty happy I fixed something, way! So yeah, just packing the tools away and that is it done. We'll have to look at the grill another time. I'll have to buy a new one probably and get it resprayed. Oh, fail. Screwdriver on the back. Fail. Screwdriver on the back and... hey, third time lucky. So that's just the little toolbox I keep emergencies. If I break down something, I've got a little bit of tools. So we're going to look at the grill another time. We're going to have to get a new one at some point. Recap, because you can see here, look, the gap around the headlight. That is shocking. So a new grill's on order. I may change the front end about visually, not quite sure, knowing that I now need to get a new grill and obviously a new bumper because it's cracked, but we will see. So we're done. I'll have to look at the grill another time. feel like this video might be a little bit short, so I'm gonna, because it's New Year's Eve, I'm gonna put some clips in of the fireworks and stuff just to end the video, which I thought would be quite nice. So enjoy.